but the fun is just beginning. She knows he's anticipating, but she's gonna keep him waiting. Grab her by the eating, and they're heading to the honky tonk. But loud crowds and line dancing just ain't what they really want. Drive out to the boondocks and park down by the creek, and where it's George Strait real late and dancing cheek to cheek. Till the sun comes up, ain't giving in till they get enough. Go around the world in a pickup truck. Ain't going down till the sun comes up.
Sports welcomes you to Music City, USA. We're in Nashville, and that was Garth Brooks who got us started. But we didn't come for the Opry. Our home for the day is the Municipal Auditorium, site of the ladies' competition in the American Skating Invitational.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Vern Lundquist, along with Scott Hamilton. Scott, the ladies' event today, 8 outstanding competitors. And in the same event, we've got Katarina Witt, Oksana Baiul, Yuka Sato. The list goes on and on. This really should be interesting.
It's going to be a great event. Oksana Baiul, the reigning Olympic champion, has had a little problem competing as a professional, but I think she's due. I really think she's due. Yuka Sato, the reigning world champion. Then you mix those with the veterans, the people that have been around for a long time. Katarina Witt, a two-time Olympic champion, up against Denise Bielman, the 1981 world champion, who comes in here with a lot of experience and a lot of success this year.
The format calls for a technical program, which accounts for 50% of the final score. That's followed by the artistic program representing the other half. And there will be 5 judges scoring on a 6.0 basis. By virtue of a draw, Oksana Baiul will be the first to skate in what has been a very troubled season. What do you think has been Oksana's problem?
Well, Oksana, it's just a lack of experience and not really understanding the professional ranks. She's out here, she's going to do a triple Lutz in the program. She's been struggling with it. She thinks she needs it, but she's not against a strong, strong technical field. All the skaters out here are very artistic, and she's a better artist than I think anybody in the history of the sport. So if she just played a little more conservative, skate clean, she'd be much better off. But she's trying too hard, and the rules change week to week in these competitions. So, you know, it's an experience level there, too, that she's got to understand the sport and know what she needs to do.
You know, the one thing you've not mentioned is the knee. You don't think that's a problem anymore?
I don't think it's a problem anymore. I think it just comes down to confidence. And, you know, it was shaken when she was struggling with her jumps when she came right back off the knee injury. But she's got all the quality. She just needs to lay back, do what she needs to do, and get the job done.
And this will be a brand new program for Oksana Baiul. She talked about that.
Nelina listen music and look TV, this clip, Enigma, and Galina said, oh my God, it's so good. Oksana, maybe we try do it this ice, in ice. I say, okay, but try, and so.
So, now you'll see it. The current Olympic gold medalist skating to music of Enigma. Here is Oksana Baiul and her technical program.
Oksana skates first. What's great about skating first is that you don't have to follow 6.0s or 5.9s from the previous competitor, and you have the feel for the ice from the warm-up. Eight required elements. First one, very important, a combination, triple Lutz into double toe loop. She hasn't been doing this well in warm-up. Triple Lutz, she hangs on to it.
Full credit.
She'll get credit, but not for a combination. She's going to have to throw a double toe loop on the end of another jump if she wants to get credit for the combination.
We have seen her improvise.
Tolu, beautifully done. The mark of a true artist is when you can take a still photo anytime during the performance and they're in perfect position. And that's one quality Oksana Bayul has over the rest of the planet. Nice double axel. She can handle any kind of music, whether it be classical, something more alternative, new age, and all that at 17 years old. And it was an easy one, but she'll get credit for the combination. Beautiful layback.
Since she suffered the knee injury in late September in Sun Valley, Idaho, that's the first time we've seen her skate a clean program. I'm sure that'll do wonders for her self-assurance.
The tempo of the music really set each jump up perfectly for her.
I understand the top part.
She needed this performance so bad, I think, just for her. Every professional competition she's done this year has really been kind of filled. This triple Lutz right here is a serious gut check. She missed almost every single one of them in the practice. A little 2 foot there in the landing, but she definitely wanted it, and she delivered it. Great job. Triple toe loop here. Watch the height and watch her right here. Perfect air position. Watch the leg come up. 1 foot landing. Perfectly done.
And the five judges. There's Randy Gardner, Sarah Kawahara, Richard Callahan. Judy Bumberg and Joseph Drewer. And the marks for required elements for Oksana Bayul.
Disparity there from the 5-6 to the 5-2. It was an easy combination, the double saka, double toe loop, and a 2 foot on the triple lutz, but those seem pretty low to me.
And the second set.
And these have to go way up. Oksana Bayul has given so much to the sport artistically. 5-8s, I don't see that either. Those are too low. Anything less than a 6-0 for Oksana Bayul is just way too low.
Her total, 55.7, technical program. Disappointing marks. When we return, Rosalind Sumner, silver medalist in 84, will be on the ice. We're back in Nashville, where Oksana Bayul has completed her technical program and disappointing marks for the Olympic gold medalist. She's with Tracy.
Scott Hamilton said that he feels that anything lower than a 6.0 artistically for you is too low. What did you think of the marks?
I'm not thinking about marks, but I'm just scared and scared for people, but I don't know, I'm very happy.
Thanks, Oksana.
Thank you.
Back in Nashville, we're next on the ice. Olympic silver medalist in 1984. She lost the gold medal to Katarina Vip. They both compete here today. Here is Rosalind Sumner from Seattle, Washington. She was a world champion 10 years before Oksana, 1983. This is the music of Jerome Kern, sung by Kiri Takanawa, Smoke Gets in Your Eyes.
Rosalind has turned professional. She's developed so much artistically. Choreography is very precise. Positions, beautiful. Takeoff to an F-Revolution. Double toe loop. This year she has a renewed love for her skating. She's always enjoyed it a great deal, but this year especially, we tour together. She's been working double sessions, not taking any days off, and just loving every second she's spending on the ice. Another double axel here. Skating extremely well. The one thing that could hurt Rosalind in this program is that she does not do triple jumps anymore.
As I once said about Katarina Vip,
who cares? Beautiful job from Rosalind Sumners.
And as a true professional, she competes here, having flown in a private plane, a six-hour plane ride to get here, battling some headwinds, along with Katarina Vip and a guy named Scott Hamilton. Roz Sumners.
Rosalind's hardest jump is a double axel. Look at the height, the air position, the confidence, everything. She just goes after this thing and just tags on a double toe loop right there. She really gets aggressive on that double axel. It's great to see.
And here are the first set of marks for Roz Sumners. These for technical merit.
These 5.5s over the 5.3s from Oksana Bayil-Shol, the combination is an important part of the base mark for these judges. 5.5 shows double axel, double toe loop combination, a lot tougher than double sakai, double toe loop. That puts her head technically over Oksana Bayil-Shol, which is going to be a huge thrill for Rosalind.
And the second set.
5.7s, 5.6s. She's a beautiful skater, it's a gorgeous program, and she's very versatile. Her artistic program is going to be a lot different. But all in all, great marks.
And the total of 55.7 for Rosalind Sumners ties her with Oksana Bayil-Shol. Next on the ice, the current Canadian professional champion, Jose Chouinard. We saw her with a wonderful performance at Christmas when she won that title in Hamilton, Ontario. This would be a brand new program for Jose Chouinard. It's going to represent a country western motif. The music sung by Trisha Yearwood and Elvis Presley.
An easy double flip. She gets amazing height in her jumps. As you'll see in this double axel here, forward takeoff, 2.5 revolutions. Triple Lutz into double toe. Triple Lutz, tilted in the air. There are mandatory deductions. A failure like that will cost her at least 0.4 of a point. Second timing.
She does still manage to smile despite a tough time on the ice. Jose Chouinard of Canada.
She's so powerful. She gets great height in her jumps. She's strong in the air. The problem is when she gets tilted, she doesn't have the soft knee to be able to just pull that landing out. Again, great height. Watch her reach back here. She'll get in the air and she'll just get tilted in the air. And again, split second timing. When you're tilted like that, there's nothing you can do. Almost an identical problem on the triple toe loop here. You'll see she goes up, gets tilted right there. Nothing you can do. It's just completely out of your control. You're in the air less than a second. So if everything is not perfect, disaster.
And the first set of marks now for José Chouinard.
5.2.
5.2s. You can see what falls due to a mark right there. 8 required elements. Amazingly close to Oksana Bayul, who did not fall.
The marks and presentation are.
And the second set of marks, these for presentation.
And you can see what 2 falls do. 5.6s aren't too bad. The 5.3s, 5.4s. The falls are so costly to the overall impression of the program. And those 2 falls are very costly for José Chouinard.
The total for José Chouinard, 53.2. That places her in third behind Rosamund Sumners and Oksana Bayul. And when we return to Nashville, 2-time Olympic gold medalist Katarina Vint. Back in Nashville, where backstage, the reigning Olympic gold medalist Oksana Bayul is ready to watch the 2-time Olympic gold medalist Katarina Vint.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the ice 1984-1988 Olympic gold medalist Katarina Vint.
For her technical program, she will skate the same piece of music that has really become identified with Katarina since her performance in the Olympics, Where Have All the Flowers Gone, composed by Pete Seeger.
Technical program. This is her long program from the Olympics, and she opens big. She needs this triple toe loop, double toe loop, triple toe. She doesn't do the combination, but she can put it in later on. And if you were on the plane with her today, you realize how big that jump was. Double axel right here, and she pulls it off. Of skating that separates it from other sports is that the performance at times has heart and soul, and this program means a lot to Katarina Vint.
And for those who might not have seen Katarina perform this program before, this is her tribute to the people of Sarajevo.
Needs a combination. And there it is.
Somehow you knew she'd find the spot.
Thank you.
kid in Lillehammer's who carries the crowd in Nashville with her. Katarina Vitt.
On the plane today, she said, I said yes. I said yes recently, but I don't know why. It seemed like a good idea at the time, but I think she's not regretting the decision at all right now.
Here's a young lady who's going to be thrilled right about now.
She skates with great speed, aggression. She just attacks this jump right here. Triple toe loop, height, air position, 1 foot landing. Not a difficult combination. It's a sequence of jumps, actually. Double salchow here. Little half loop. Mazurka double flip. It'll be interesting to see how these marks compare to Oksana Bayul's.
And the marks for Katarina Vitt.
Well, these shouldn't be booed. I mean, we saw Oksana Bayul do a 2 foot triple lutz, the triple toe loop. These marks are much higher than Oksana's. The program, again, it's a beautifully constructed program.
I think she may want to talk to judge number four here on the second set of marks.
Again, the quality of the performance, she's a professional, she knows how to present herself, all that experience, very comfortable with an audience, great performance.
And Katarina's score of 56.6 puts her on top at this point in the competition. She leads Roz Sumners and Oksana Bayul. Current leader here in Nashville, and she's with Tracy Wilson.
Katarina, we're used to seeing this program as an artistic program or a long program. Why did you decide to do it as your technical program?
Well, because I have more jumps in it than in my technical, what I usually thought of my technical. And then all the programs are so new right now, and we've been working on so many different programs, so I'm not really secure. And then the response on this program for the last couple competitions I did was so big, so I thought I'm going to do it as a technical, and I feel comfortable with it because it makes me just so nervous going into a competition. So I thought, okay, I'll take a program which I feel comfortable with.
Now, you talk about being nervous going into a competition. We watch you sometimes struggle with your triple jumps on practice, yet when it comes time to do them, you're able to rise to the occasion. How do you do that?
I don't know. It's probably the adrenaline. You know, it just puts me through it, and it's just I go out there, and then all of a sudden it's different than in practice. You know, I have this extra edge to go for it. You know, sometimes in practice you're a little relaxed, and then here you go out, and the response from the audience is always so great. So then I'm standing there, and I'm going like, okay, just enjoy the program and go for it. Be aggressive, and that seems to work.
Oh, great. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Next on the ice, the oldest competitor in this event. What a season Denise Bielman is having, with wins already in St. Louis and Cleveland, and a second place finish during Christmas to José Chouinard in Canada. The 1981 world champion, Denise Bielman from Switzerland.
She has been so solid in every competition. Always under control, never skating above her ability. Double axel. That was tilted a little bit outside. Not used to seeing her tilt those jumps like that. Her next jumping pass is her combination triple toe loop into double toe loop. Perfect. Double flip. Get the jumps over with at the beginning of the program. Now it's time to skate. Thank you. Denise's skating that she really focuses on, a lot of skaters ignore it, is spinning. That is the first time I've ever seen her miss that. It's a signature move, and she just says, what the heck, I'm going to step right back into it. That is something you never see. Never.
She has really got to be dazed by that.
Sometimes you can just catch an edge and it'll just take you where you don't want to go, and that's what happened with Denise. She went to reach back for her leg and her blade went the wrong way. Very costly error. Never see her make mistakes like that. She's reaching right here, and right there she starts to catch an edge. She delivered the triple toe loop, double toe loop perfectly. The double axle was tilted outside and she saved it. And then on a spin, you can see her mother going, okay, she's counting it, and it's so, what happened there? I don't, ooh, that's not good.
Her mom and coach Heidi by her side. She's been her coach since Denise was five. Now we'll see if that fall on the Bielman spin was costly. Here are the first set of marks.
5.8, 5.8, 5.6, 5.8. And these are extremely high. She was the only one to really hit a triple-double combination. That's a very important aspect of the marks. But 5.8 with a fall on a spin, that is, they must have been judging on a 6.2 or 6.1 scale.
You're saying they were generous.
Very generous.
Second set of marks for Denise Bielman.
Again, the element she did very well, and it's a perfect technical program the way it's constructed. She's in great condition, but that fall should have cost her a lot more.
I wonder if she's surprised to find herself in first place. At any rate, that's where she is. Katarina Witt is second. Bayulen Sumner is tied for third. Next to skate here in Nashville, the current world champion Yuka Sato. And therein lies a story. It was an Olympic drama unlike any before. The bizarreness of it all left us believing ladies figure skating couldn't get any stranger. We were wrong. That night in Lillehammer, there were two skaters who didn't make the headlines. Japan's Yuka Sato. Surya Bonaly from France. For them, less than 1 month later, skating took another bizarre twist. The top three ladies from the Olympics chose to bow out of the World Championships in Tokyo. That left Bonaly, the fourth place finisher from the Olympics, and Sato, the fifth place finisher, as the favorites. Skating in front of a hometown crowd, Sato won the technical program. In the free skate, her style and footwork gave her higher artistic marks than Bonaly. Sato won by a score of just 5-4. For Surya Bonaly, the defeat was heartbreaking. When it was time to award the medals, Bonaly was nowhere to be found. She finally came out, but refused to stand on the podium. Then she refused to accept her silver medal. When it was finally put around her neck, she took it off. It was a moment in life she would rather forget.
At this moment, I was just upset, and it was a good, bad moment at this time, and just, I feel like this, but now, from way back, I think I have to forget this, and just, it was a past now, it's a past. Why I don't want to think this anymore, and just I wish this will be not again another time like this.
For Sato, Bonaly's disappointment at not winning the World Championship was unfortunate but understandable.
She's been working so hard for a long time, and you know, it just didn't happen, but it was so close, so you know, she must be disappointed too, and I could understand that.
1994, a year of memorable moments some people would like to forget. ladies' technical program continues. The current world champion, Yuka Sato from Tokyo.
We talk a lot about the required elements. Yuka Sato is probably the most recent professional. World championships were held last March. We talk about the required elements. Let's go through them one at a time. The layback spin, first of the three required spins. For her first of three jumps that she will do. Actually, this is a two-jump combination, triple lutz and a double toe. Double lutz. She's going to have to find a place for a combination because this program is set up purely as a technical program. Footwork sequence right here, straight line step. She's got great footwork. Jump into this position. That's a beautiful flying camel.
Well, thank you for the tour through that program. That was very educational. And I think it shows all of us how improvisational these programs sometimes have to be.
The last thing you want to do is improvise when you're doing a technical program. You program yourself, muscle memory, you can depend on that when your nerves are at their worst. And she got pretty creative out there. Another look at the triple lutz that turned into a double. She just, right there, she goes, nope, nope. It's an instant reflex that happens. You get up in the air and you know that it's not going to happen. This was supposed to be a plain old, average, everyday, run-of-the-mill triple loop, which she doesn't have one. She has a beautiful triple loop. Look at the air position here. Great position. She goes, oh, I need a double toe loop, and I'm just going to put it right there. And now I have the most difficult combination done so far in the competition. Thank you very much.
Now we'll see how the judges viewed Yuka Sato's performance. First set of marks.
And the marks for Cardellis are 5.8, 5.4.
Well, sometimes the judges get programmed into watching the practices and knowing when the skaters make mistakes. Even though she delivered the jumps, the one single flip probably stuck out a little bit, even though it wasn't a required element. The 5.4s, I think, are a little severe.
Second set of marks, Scott.
And these are very good. Maybe she should have fallen on a spin. She might have been better off.
Because the total of these marks put her second behind Denise Bielman. It's Bielman, Sato, Katarina Vip. We'll be back in just a moment. Nashville, we're next on the ice from Erie, Pennsylvania. Here is Karen Kadavy. Bronze medalist in Cincinnati in the World Championships of 1987.
When just you love and never get love.
A duet between Natalie Cole and Reba McEntire.
If I were picking music to skate to in a technical program, I don't think I would pick a piece of music with the word fell or fall or anything like that in it.
I can't get you out of my
first jumping pass is her most difficult combination. Triple toe loop into double toe loop. Triple toe. Little step out there. Double toe loop. Second jump here is a double axel. Beautiful double axel. You'll see a lot of the skaters doing their jumping passes in the beginning of the program because that's when you're least tired. When your legs are fresh, they can recover from any mistakes you have in the air. Skater.
Four times a medalist at the U.S. Nationals, the highest, second in 1986. Now the wife of a doctor in Erie, Pennsylvania, Karen Kadavy.
When the warm-up she was having a little trouble, she was stabbing at the toe a little bit on the takeoff. This one she had perfect extension back here, got a little more height she knew what to do with, a little over-rotated there, left hip opened up, couldn't hang on to the landing. But easy double toe loop there, minor deduction, a tenth, maybe two. Double axel here, she'll step forward. Good air position, 1 foot landing, no problems with this whatsoever. She makes it look easy. It's a tough jump sometimes because that edge can get away from you.
And the marks for Guardiola is off 5.7.
Here are the marks for Karen Kadavy.
5.7, 5.5, you can see the deduction on the step out on the combination. Still very good marks.
And the marks for presentation.
5.7. 5.6.
That's interesting, a 5.6. Beautiful presentation, nicely constructed programs. I think the 5.8 was a little closer to where I would have judged it.
56.9 for Karen Kadavy. So the current standings have Bielman first, and Karen Kadavy is in second place, followed by Yuka Sato, Katarina Witt. Then come Roslyn Summers and Oksana Bayul. Get you current on the standings. Denise Bielman in the lead, followed by Karen Kadavy, Yuka Sato, Katarina Witt. Then come Roslyn Summers and Oksana Bayul. And Tracy Wilson is with the current leader.
Denise, this is your trademark spin. Nobody does it as well as you do. You had trouble with it today. What happened?
Yeah, I was a little bit tired to the end of the program, and I just came 2 days before to the States, and suddenly my legs felt heavy, and so I lost the balance.
Has this ever happened to you before?
Yeah, maybe 10 years ago, one time when I was skating outside in rain, and this time.
It's a difficult spin that you make look easy.
Yeah, it is very difficult, and it looks always so easy, but this time the people can see maybe that's not so easy.
Thanks, Denise.
Thank you.
Oksana Bayo will be on the ice when we return. Well, it is a real surprise after the technical program to find Oksana Bayul in sixth place once the tiebreaker is taken into account. Denise Bielman is currently in the lead, Karen Kadavy second, followed by Yuka Sato and Katarina Witt. I am really surprised, Scotty. I think if I'm a handicapper and I've got an Olympic gold medalist here, I would not think she'd be sixth at this point.
The only way I can figure it is that the double sockeye double toe loop really cost her in the judges' eyes. Looking at the other performances, there were a lot of mistakes. Oksana Bayul is a gorgeous artistic skater. Her second marks were good, but not as good as I thought they could have been. Again, I'm a bit confused. Oksana Bayul has had kind of a monkey on her back all year trying to put down a good performance. This program was very good. It just wasn't good in the judges' eyes. Very surprised.
Are you shocked to see Denise Bielman in first place?
A little bit, yeah. She delivers the goods. She did a nice, big triple-toe, double-toe combination of the tech program, but she fell on a spin. That's a mandatory deduction. The judges, I think, ignored that mandatory deduction and went on. But it's important here. There are five judges. Everybody has their own opinion. Everybody has a way of evaluating skating. These are all judges from different backgrounds, so it's a kind of an interesting combination on how they present their marks and what they're looking for. It's a little confusing to me, but if I were on the panel, I think I would have judged it a little bit differently.
Well, I think it's fair to say the judges might have demonstrated some confusion. Look at the first place vote. Sato with two, Bielman with two, Kadavy got one. For second place, Katarina Witt got 2 second place votes, Bielman got two, and Kadavy one. And for third place, Kadavy two, Oksana Bayul moves in. Roz Sumners and Yuka Sato complete the list. Scotty, how would you have ranked them 1, 2, 3?
Well, it's a tough call. I mean, each program had its own strength and its own qualities. I probably would have had Sato first, Bayul second, and Bielman on the strength of the triple-toe combination, just a little bit ahead of Katarina Witt.
Well, surprisingly, in a tie for fifth place right now on the ice for the artistic program, here is the 1994 Olympic gold medalist, Oksana Bayul. And she's chosen to skate to a familiar piece called Ave Maria.
Triple Toler. so unique and special. I haven't seen a skater like this since the late 60s, Janet Lynn.
She was an unknown. She competed in the Soviet National Championships in Kiev, and she finished 12th. From that point to this is the first time she's come into a competition sixth going into the artistic program. I think she's a little exasperated.
She's been looking for answers on how to do better in professional competitions. This triple sow cow, it looked like she was just a little past it on the rotation here. But beautifully landed nevertheless. Great technique on jumps, and look at the position on this spin. Flexibility, quality, artistry. It's just a joy to watch her skate.
What is now a very familiar sight, Galina Smievskaya by the side of Oksana Bayul as they wait for the scores from the five judges.
5'8", 1'5", 7". All in all, not too bad. The triple sack out, triple toe loop, those are the easier of the triple jumps. She didn't do a triple lutz in this program.
And the marks for presentation.
Straight across the board, 5'9". Again, she's a 6'0", 6'1", 6'2", in my book.
I'll tell you what, it's not enough to make Galina Smievskaya smile. But Oksana can't help it. She's always got a grin for the world. And that puts her with a total of 114.1. Back in a moment. It's in Nashville, Tennessee, at the Nashville Municipal Auditorium. And the next to compete, Rosalind Sumners. She'll skate to the music of Pat Benatar. It's called True Love.
Something completely different.
Back in the long Nobel Prize.
thing about professional competitions. It allows you to do whatever you want to do. This is one of Rosalind's favorites. And mine.
In 1984, Roz Sumners finished second to Katarina Witt by 1/10 of a point at the Olympics in Sarajevo. Now they tour together, and here they are competing on the same patch of ice.
Double axel, she just goes after this. She backs off it just a little bit on the takeoff right there, a little bit tilted, but she has enough room in the air to be able to right herself and perfect landing. Rosalind's not afraid of choreography. You can see that right there. She loves this program.
Sultry comes to mind. Now the marks for Rosalind Sumners.
And these aren't too bad. She does not do triple jumps anymore. Double axel is her hardest jump, and the judges are looking for that. You can see 4 and 5 like the difficulty of the program and the choreography. Again, all these judges are from different backgrounds. They're all looking for different things in the programs.
And the second set of marks for presentation.
And these should go up, and they do. It's a beautiful program. It really shows a whole different side of Rosalind. 5'8", and another 5'8". She's got to be happy with that.
Roz Sumners' total score, 111.3. Katarina Witt is next. Yuka Sato waiting in the wings. Back in Nashville, Tennessee, the ladies' artistic program at the American Skating Invitational. Currently in fourth place going into the artistic program, Katarina Witt. And she will skate music from a Broadway musical called Elizabeth, the title of the tune, I Belong to Me.
With her. Opening jump, triple toe loop. Slightly two-footed, but this is a program with no mandatory deductions.
On your own.
Program accounts for 50% of the total score.
Bye.
That could almost be her personal anthem.
She was very nervous about this performance, this competition. She had a rough travel day today. 6 hours on a small plane after opening night, Stars on Ice last night. So she's happy to come out, stay vertical, get the crowd on their feet. She just invites the entire audience to come onto the ice with her. It's just great to see her perform.
Now the scores for Katarina Witt. Technical merit.
And these are very good. 5-7. Triple toe loop at the beginning of the program obviously was very important in the judges' eyes, and she skated with a lot of speed and confidence.
And the second set.
And these are excellent marks as well. Well, she not only survived this competition, she did very well.
I don't think she knows it yet, but she soon will. She leads Oksana Fayul, the Olympic gold medalist, by 0.1 point. Back on the ice in Nashville. And the next to compete, the current world champion.
World champion, Yuka Sato.
From Tokyo, here is Yuka Sato. Diana Ross.
Yuka has so many qualities, one of them jumping, triple loop here. Jumper and also a very good spinner. She combines all that with speed, great footwork, and beautiful presentation. Very difficult triple Sakow out of the Nina Bauer.
Yuka came into this part of the competition trailing by only 0.6 of a point.
Beautiful position on that camel spin to this layback. Scratch spin. Just a perfect performance from Yuka Sato.
Every time we see her, and we see a lot of her, she seems to grow. Child of two Olympians, Kumiko and Nobuo Sato, and the world champion.
She combines so many beautiful elements. This Ina Bauer here position, she just steps backwards and goes right into a triple salchow. This is so difficult. Notice the air position here and the beautiful landing. Combination spin, camel spin right here. Look at the extension of not only the leg but the hands. Perfect position on this outside edge on the spinning leg into a layback. One problem Yuka might have is that she does everything so textbook that you can take it for granted.
Now we'll see if the judges were impressed. The first set of marks for technical merit.
And these are not too bad. 5.8 to 5.7. This is a very difficult program. The triple salchow was perfect right off the Ina Bauer, and the triple loop was gorgeous. Beautiful skating.
And 5.8. I think Yuka Sato likes what she's seen thus far. Now we'll get the second set of marks.
5.7, 5.9.
Some disparity there. They go down to 5.7 from a couple of judges to 5.9. Ballads sometimes don't have an impact on the judges, and they get very average marks.
The total of 114.5 for Yuka Sato. That puts her in first place for the moment in front of Kanarita Vitt and Oksana Bayul. Denise Bielman and Karen Kadavy. On the ice when we return. Back in Nashville and currently in second place, here is 27-year-old Karen Kadavy. And to honor the recently completed Christmas season, she's chosen to compete to a Christmas song, O Come All Ye Faithful, performed by Donna Summer.
Really lovely. Karen Kababy.
Times I watch Karen, I just get mesmerized. I'll just sit here and watch. And she's a beautiful performer. And look here at triple toe loop. She'll reach back with that left foot, vault three times around in the air. A little forward on the landing, but one foot very clean. And then look at the triple loop that she doubled. Watch, she'll go right here and go whoop. Right there, the leg comes out. She knows that she can't complete the rotation, so she has to stop.
Very emotional. Marks for technical merit, 5.6.
Now the marks for technical merit for Karen Kababy.
She did a nice triple toe loop at the beginning of the program, but I think the triple loop that she doubled, it was very apparent. It was right in front of the judges, and I think that stuck out in their eye.
And marks for presentation.
I'm sorry, I've heard 5.6, 5.5. These are low. She's a wonderful performer. Every movement is very big. Great crowd response. That's surprising that they're as low as 5.5.
Okay.
Karen Kadavy's total, 112.9, and that drops her all the way to fourth. Yuka Sato has the lead, followed by Katarina Witt and Oksana Bayul. Denise Bielman is next to skate. And now for the leader, and what a season she has had. Here is 32-year-old Denise Bielman. She will skate to the music of Hector Villalobos. This is a piece called Bacchianus Brasileiras. Denise Bielman.
Triple sow cow. A little close to the wall, but beautifully landed. She's just so strong, so consistent. Triple toe loop here. More room than she needs in the air to do three revolutions. Rest of the field is her athleticism is her focus. A lot of the women competing will use the flow, the femininity, the artistry. Denise moves more in angular movements, much more inward in her presence. presentation. Sometimes it's hard to get a hold of it, her choreography. She's in such great condition all the time. You can always depend on her for a solid performance. Move a scratch spin. Watch her lean her head back. So difficult.
Denise Bielman and her mom Heidi. I think mom thinks it was enough to win.
Well, it's going to be interesting. Again, there's two marks here. There's the technical, and the second mark reflects the artistry. Technically, she was as clean as could be. It'll be interesting to see how the judges react to her artistry. It's just different than everybody else. This triple toe loop, look at the height. She's skating with a great deal of speed. So much room in the air. Nice loose position there. A lot of speed coming down. Easy double toe loop on the end of the landing. Then you can see her mother watching her. Yes, that was good. Okay. Oh, this is so exciting. Triple salchow again, a strength move. It's off the inside edge there. One, two, three, and out. No problem whatsoever into another double toe loop to make it a combination. Athletically so strong. Doesn't warm up, doesn't need to. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
And now the marks for Denise Bielman.
5'8", 5'9", 5'9", 5'7", there.
Yuka Sato hoping now. And Denise Bielman, here are the second set of marks.
These are great. 5'8", oh, the 5'6".
Whoa.
That'll be enough to give her the title. 5.7.
Indeed it will. Denise Bielman with a total of 115.5. And she adds the Nashville crown to previous competitions she won in St. Louis and Cleveland, and a second place finish at the Canadian Professional Championships. Bielman wins it. Yuka Sato is second, followed by Katarina Witt, Oksana Bayul, Karen Kadavy, and Ross Sumners. We'll talk with the champion after this. Back in Nashville, where the American Skating Invitational has come to a close, and a disappointing day for Oksana Bayul, Scott.
She's 17 years old, the first year she's been a professional. There's so much you have to learn as a pro to be competitive in this business of figure skating, but she's going back to the eligible ranks. She's going to compete again in the Olympic Games, and I think that's where she belongs at this point in her career.
Yuka Sato, a strong artistic program and a second place finish.
She did everything she needed to do to beat Denise Bielman, except she didn't convince the judges. I really felt that she deserved this competition.
And if there has been a dominant competitor in the professional ranks this fall and winter, it has been Denise Bielman.
Experience, experience, experience. She's been through so many of these professional competitions. She knows what she needs to do to win. She puts her programs together, and she's solid as a rock.
It will come as small consolation, but the Olympic gold medalist did win the artistic part of this competition. Oksana Bayul finishes first in the artistic over Denise Bielman, but the artistic mark not enough to compensate for the low technical mark she received. So Denise Bielman is the winner, followed by Yuka Sato, then Katarina Witt, and Oksana Bayul. And Denise Bielman is standing by with Tracy Wiss.
Denise, you're getting the reputation as being unbeatable. This has just been an incredible season for you, hasn't it?
Yeah, it is actually my best season. I think I did win now three competitions in a few weeks, and it's great. It's just great.
Can you put your finger on what is making you so successful?
Well, I don't know. I'm just training very hard, and I try to give always my best, if it's exhibition or competition, and yeah, and maybe also a little bit of luck also.
Well, congratulations, Denise. Pleasure to watch.
Thank you.
For Scott Hamilton and Tracy Wilson, I'm Vern Lundquist saying goodbye from Nashville. We leave you with some of the memorable pictures from this figure skating season. And in keeping with our current Music City surroundings, the song comes from Conway Twitty.
My one and only prayer is that someday you'll care. My hopes, my dreams come true. My one and only you, no one will ever know. I love you so. My only prayer will be someday you care for me, but it's only make-believe. My hopes, my dreams come true. My life I'd give for you. My heart a wedding ring. My heart I can't control. You rule my very soul. My only prayer will be someday you care for me, but it's only make-believe. My one and only prayer is that someday you care. My hopes, my dreams come true.